Hey friends, I'm here on Zoom recording this message to you because I've noticed that in a lot of the conversations I've had recently, you, my wonderful students, have said things like, well, I know I'm not really good at math. I just do this for fun. So, or I don't know if I'm good enough to be a math major, but, or I struggle a lot with math. I know I'm not the smartest, or variations on a theme of I'm dumb because I struggle with math. And I can't let it go. I'm gonna sit here and have a monologue at you because we do this in office hours, but I recognize that this is the remote semester, so I gotta do it a different way. First, I wanna recognize that I notice this behavior in myself too. I tend to say, I'm not like a super great mathematician, I'm an okay mathematician, or I am competent at my research, but not the best researcher in the world, or all of these statements that qualify how good I am, or maybe express how not good I am at mathematics. And that's something that I think doesn't serve any of us well. So I'm gonna try to stop doing that. Let's just stop, right? Super easy. Just totally change the way I think about myself. I wanted to share for a second my own path through mathematics, starting with failing math in seventh grade pre-algebra. I got really mad at math and I was like, I'm gonna finish it. I'm not good at it, I'm just pissed at it, and I'm gonna finish math. So I, you know, caught up. I skipped a year of history, finished Calc BC in high school, and I was like, great, wash my hands, no more math to be done, that's it, that's where math stops. And then I went to college. I dropped out of college. Talk about feeling not good enough. Dropped out before I flunked out, in all honesty. Spent some time working, finished my first year near home, and then transferred out to Colorado College, where I was planning on being a French major because French wasn't that hard for me. I was pretty good at French. And I thought, well, you should, you know, major in what you're good at. And I was like, maybe going to do econ, work for the World Bank. Some of you have heard me tell this story before. You know that I'm definitely on track for that goal, just doing it the long way. But what happened was I was going to this place where I, you know, like this meet your professors thing under this big tent. And I ran into this guy and we had like matching Converse sneakers on or something. And he's like, oh, hey, I'm teaching Calc 3. And I was like, oh, I finished calculus and I'm done with math. And he's like, no, take Calc 3. And he was explaining what we were going to do. And he's like, we're going to parameterize the way a leaf falls from a tree. And I was like, okay, well, first of all, I didn't know that there was more math to do and I'm pissed and I'm gonna finish math. So I guess I have to take this class. And also that sounds kind of cool. So I took Calc 3, I did okay, but I felt like it was a struggle. I felt like I didn't automatically know how to do all the problems. I'd have to go back and look at examples and go and get help. And I saw people sailing through this class, you know, seemingly effortless. And the place where I went, you take one class at a time. So this professor was like, what are you taking next semester? And I was like, oh, I'm gonna take this French class. And he's like, no, don't take that French class, take differential equations. And I was like, well, what do you mean? He's like, well, now that you know all this calculus, you should at least see how to use it. And I was like, all right, fine, but this is it. I'm done after this. Like, I've seen math, I don't need any more math. And so I'm taking differential equations and I secretly am kind of liking it. But I see these people just sailing through and it's like effortless for them. And I'm like, why is this hard for me? Why do I have to do all this extra work to get through it? This must mean that I'm not a math person. And I hear that from some of you. Like, this is why I'm telling you this story, because I recognize sometimes some of us are on the same wavelength. At least some of you are on the same wavelength with young Professor Gibbons, which might scare you. And that's reasonable. Like, if you're scared, you can just turn off this video now and pretend you never saw any of it. But if this is resonating with you, keep listening. So I then, of course, ended up taking nothing but math and computer science, essentially, in my first year. I took a computer science class that I had none of the prerequisites for. There, I really was out of my depth, but that was nice to see, like, oh, this is what it's really like to not belong in a classroom. I don't know how to do any of this. And then I took linear algebra, and then I took number theory, which was, it was called number theory, but it was really an intro to proofs class. And then I forget, I took a bunch of math classes. And I was like, you know what? I don't care that it doesn't come as easily for me, because this is really fun. I like these puzzles and I like the feeling of triumph when I struggle and I overcome this thing. And what happened in my second year was I started to notice that there were parts of math that I was good at, but I've been telling myself for so long that I'm not a math person that I hadn't even been able to see that I was actually good at some of this stuff. Like there were some things where it was like, okay, not all of it comes easily, but that piece, that makes sense to me. Like somewhere at a deep level, I'm like, aha, like that is a thing that I believe. For me, it happened to be algebra. There's a moment in the modern algebra class you're taking right now, where something clicked for me and I was like, this is how we talk about relationships. This is how we understand how this thing is related to that thing. And there's a whole subject, algebra, that's all about operations and structure and form and relationships. And that to me was just really compelling. And I was like, okay, like I kind of knew I was going to be a math major because I'd essentially almost finished the math major by taking almost eight classes in math in my first year. And I was like, no. I'm going to major in math now because I want to, not because I accidentally did. So French plans, whatever. In my senior year, I think I ended up taking some French classes. But it was interesting to me to feel like I wasn't very good at math, but I liked it enough that I was going to do it anyway. And then what happened later, I'm going to skip over a big chunk of time here. Later in grad school, I had gone through the coursework and stuff. Same deal. I wasn't like sailing through it. It didn't come easily to me, but I enjoyed it for the most part. There were some moments where I was like, this math is kind of yucky and I hope I never have to do it again, which guarantees that it will be in your dissertation, by the way. So be careful if you say that. If you say you hate real analysis, there will be at least one part of your dissertation that involves real analysis. Trust me, I know. Anyway, I get to the point of grad school where you stop taking classes and you start doing research. And for me, it was a transition, but it was mostly looking at reading papers, being stuck, trying to work out examples, trying to figure out if other papers had been written about those papers that I could learn from, having questions about what was going on, and realizing that being stuck in class had prepared me to be stuck in research. A lot of those people that I had watched in grad school sail through the classes suddenly get to research and they're like, what? I'm stuck? This sucks. I hate this. I hate this feeling being stuck and I'm out. And some of them left grad school. And I thought those were the people who were good at math. But it turns out that being good at math is actually being good at being stuck. That feels so wrong to say, right? Like that feels wrong to hear probably. But being good at math is being good at being stuck. And what I mean is not like just being stuck and like living your life stuck, but being stuck and thinking, okay, I'm stuck. What's the next step? I'm going to find an example. I'm going to think about this from a different perspective. I'm going to talk to somebody about this. I'm going to see what's out there that I don't know that I could learn about that would help me in this particular problem that I'm interested in. And it turned out that all that time I had been stuck in classes and trying to figure out how to learn in these classes, those were the tools that I needed to be a mathematician. I mean, I need the math too sometimes. And sometimes I forget it and I have to go look it up. But it turns out that all that time figuring out how to learn math that I didn't know and also push the edge of my own ignorance, that's what research is. It's just that you're pushing the boundary of everybody's ignorance. And so you might be stuck for longer. And I wish someone had told that to me. I wish someone had said to me, Courtney Gibbons, these feelings that you have of being not good at math, what you're feeling is the uncomfortable feeling of practicing what it takes to be good at math. The being stuck, the getting unstuck, the admitting that you don't know something, which can sometimes be really scary. And so for those of you that I've talked to recently who have said things like, I'm not good at math, or I see people that do it a lot faster, or just generally, I don't know if this is for me. If you have fun doing it, if you like doing it, it's for you. If you like it enough that you don't mind the feeling of being stuck, it's for you. That's what it takes to be a mathematician. That's it. And I hope that you hear this from me as a person now who has a PhD in math and a master's in math and a bachelor's in math and is a tenured professor of mathematics who has had, you know, National Science Foundation money to conduct research in math, who still sometimes feels the same way you do. Doing math is being stuck. And if you are in modern algebra or in any math class and you feel like you've been stuck, welcome. Welcome, my people. Math is for you. If you would like to have a follow-up conversation with me about any of the stuff that I've talked about here, I would be more than happy to talk to you, and I hope you'll take me up on that.